Welcome everyone. Now let's talk about the components of the computer, the hardware components. Okay, so hardware is one of the components of the computer. What does hardware mean? Here is the definition of the hardware. It's basically the physical components of the computers. Okay, all the physical components of the computer that you see are known as the hardware. Okay. So those components, they work together to enable the computer to perform various tasks. Without the hardware, the computer will not be able to perform the various tasks. And those hardwares, the most common ones, it includes the case, power supply unit, the motherboard, and CPU, or also known as central processing unit, and the main memory, RAM, graphic cards, okay, secondary storage devices, as well as the input and output devices. So those are the most common hardwares. And first of all, the case. So what is a case? It is basically the enclosure that contains the most of the components of the computer. It is this enclosure. Okay, so generally it's the case is steel or aluminum or plastic. It comes in different sizes. Yes, it contains the components such as power units. Okay, power unit supply, and also the motherboard, CPU, hard drive, and graphic cards, everything are contained in this case. Okay. And inside the case, we do have this essential hardware such as power supply unit. Okay. What is power supply unit is for in the computer? The name itself, it should tell you it is for the power supply. Okay, the power supply unit, it converts the electrical power from an outlet into the computer and distributes the power to various components. Okay, it provides the power to things like mainboard, CPU, hard drive, graphic cards, cooling system, or fans, pretty much to all the hardwares it is going to supply the power to. Okay. And this motherboard, well, this motherboard, it is basically a board, okay? This board, it holds together many of the crucial components of the computer. So it serves as a central hub that connects and allows communication between all those hardware components. And it is essential for the proper functioning integration of all the hardware components within the computer or in any other electronic device. Okay, pretty much all the electronic devices, they do have motherboard. Okay, and in this motherboard, the most important crucial piece of the hardware on the motherboard is the CPU. Stands for central processing unit. Okay, you can see the CPU as the brain of the computer or brain of the electronic device. Okay, it is the brain because it is responsible for doing all the works. It is also known as the processor. When you hear the term processor, it is basically the CPU, the central processing unit. Okay, and CPU speed and processing power directly impacts the performance and speed of the tasks. Okay, it is crucial for the overall performance and functionality of a computer. CPU is important. And correlated to the CPU, we have the main memory, or also called random access memory. Okay, in short, it is called RAM. So it is a memory place in the computer that is dedicated to the CPU. Okay, it's a memory place where the data is stored. where the data is stored for the processor, in order to run the applications and the open the files. Okay. So basically, whatever the data that the CPU needed, those data will be stored in this RAM memory. Not just any other files that you saved in your computer, only the data that are needed for the CPU will be stored into the RAM memory. So usually RAM sizes are like 4 gigabytes or 6 gigabytes or 8 gigabytes. So, and this RAM, it is a small storage for the fast access purpose. That's why it's not like hard drive, like 100 gigabyte or something. It is usually it's just 4 gigabyte or 8 gigabytes. And the data will be erased once the supply to the storage device is turned off. Okay? So this is main memory. And then we have the secondary storage devices as the hardware of the computer. Those secondary storage devices, they are not the essential parts. They are not the essential hardware of the computer. They are the non-essential storage devices that is internally or externally to the computer. Okay? So it's either internal or external to the computer, but the computer does not need it in order to perform its task. So those secondary storage devices, they include HDD and SSD. HDD, it stands for hard disk drive. Okay? SSD stands for solid state drive. And you might also know this USB flash drive. The small piece of flash drive that you can store the files, store some applications in it. It is also called secondary storage devices. Okay. Besides that, we also have optical disk. The disk like this, you can also store some files in it. And they are known as the non-essential storage devices because they do not impact the normal functioning of the computer. Okay. And besides the secondary storage, we also have the graphic card. Okay. It's also known as the graphic processing unit or GPU. So the GPU, it is responsible for rendering the image and the visual content to the display. Okay. It significantly enhances the visual performance, quality, and overall user experiences in an application. So graphic card is basically the one that rendering the images and visual content. And we also have the input devices as the hardwares. So what is the input devices? What are the main use cases of the input devices? Well, the input devices, they are used for facilitate the communication between you and the computer. Okay, that's what input devices are for. And it enables the user to interact and control the device's operations. For example, if you want to open a file in your computer, what you do? You will use the mouse and double click it, right? And if you want to search something on the Google website, what do you need to do? You need to type it in the search box. In order to type it, what do you need? You need the keyboard, right? And imagine if you don't have those input devices. Then the communication with the computer would be much more difficult. Okay? So those input devices, they facilitate the communication between us and computer. Between the user and computers. Okay? And we also have the output devices as the hardwares of the computer. Okay? So what are output devices are for? Well, basically output devices, they allow the computer system to present information, right? Or to give the output to the user. Okay? So it is basically used for completing the communication loop between the user and the device. For example, if I wanted to open the YouTube in my computer and watch the video. To be able to watch the video, I still need to have monitor, right? If I don't have the monitor, then I cannot watch it. So the computer, it used this monitor, okay? It used this hardware to present me the information, the outputs to me. Okay. So the common example of output devices are like this: the monitor, printer, and speaker, headphone, projector. Each of them are used for the giving the output to the user. Okay, it is basically the opposite of input devices. Input devices, we have like keyboard, mouse, joystick, scanner, webcam, and microphone, right? Which allows us to communicate with the computer, okay? But if you want to get the output and return it to us, if you want the computer to process the data and return the output to us, then the computer does need the output devices in order to complete the communication loop between the user and computer. Okay, so those are the hardwares of the computer. In the next video, we will be talking about the software and the another component of the computer. See you all in the next lecture.